It's a kind of, suppose there is a monument, it is a lithic history, history written on stone. So if you are an archaeologist, if you have got the basic architecture, I mean, if you know architecture, if you know certain historical background about these things, then you will be able to put a tongue in each and every stones. And these stones will speak to you in a tune and tone that is completely conversant to you. For example, you go to Qutub Minar, you go to the Tanjore Temple, you go to Mahabalipuram, any of these monuments. If you know the history and if you know the art, if you know the architecture, then it is very easy for you to put a tongue in each and every stone, and then those stones will speak to you. So that is the best part of it. I mean, about the socio-cultural movement of the period, its economic aspect of the period, everything. I mean, you will be having the entire history before you. You can build upon its own.